Arthur meets an old mate.
Ron, Arthur,
how are you?
What is it, 5 years now?
Three, Arthur, with good behaviour. What'll they be?
Offers some advice.
Dead meat and chips. That's the preference of the great British palate. Not free-range yoghurt with a sprinkle and a trill.
And tries to make a little earner.
Arthur, I'm okay on security. Meet Sid. As in, vicious.
But ends up in need of a minder. Thursday at 9 on TVS.
On TVS in a few moments, the news, weather and sport from ITN and Nicholas Owen after the break.
Unlike some, Batchelor's Microchef are snacks specially made for the microwave. Microwaves just love Microchef from Batchelor's.
Your skin is vulnerable every day in summer and winter to moisture loss and the aging effects of ultraviolet rays. But now you can defend yourself with new UV Daily Defense Body Lotion from Vaseline Intensive Care. Its UV screens help defend exposed skin against age spots and wrinkles. Its unique moisturizing formula defends against moisture loss. It's your first line of defense every day. New UV from Vaseline Intensive Care. Now you can defend your youth at any age.
Pain like this could mean you have sensitive teeth. But here's a solution. McLean Sensitive. It tastes like an ordinary toothpaste, but with regular brushing, McLean Sensitive's advanced formula targets the cause of the pain. Microscopic holes that lead straight to the nerve. By sealing those holes, McLean Sensitive helps stop the pain of sensitive teeth fast. McLean Sensitive seals the holes, relieves the pain.
Savings plan from Equity and Law. Very sensible. Automatic rotary action cat polisher. Not so sensible.
Equity in Law. Polished performance since 1844.
Life was tough in the old Wild West, and every man had to work his way up.
One day we'll strike big. And when we do, I'll pay you off myself.
The going was tough, and the opposition even tougher. Till a lean, mean preacher man rode into town and made his mark.
Nothing like a nice piece of hickory.
Get the hell out of cotton candy now.
You wouldn't want me to leave before I finish my work, would you?
Clint Eastwood is the Pale Rider, tonight at 9:05.
David Bobin introduces the best of the afternoon's action in the Rugby World Cup beginning at 11:10. And then programmes into Sunday morning begin with Tour of Duty at 12:10, focusing on the effects on the base of the assassination of Martin Luther King. This is TVS, now the news from ITN in London.
The news from ITN.
Nurses injured as Yugoslav rescue convoy moves out. Labour ahead in first poll after the conferences. Biggest car park firm's boss faces fraud charges. And England beat France, they meet Scotland in the semi-final. Good evening. An international relief convoy has rescued more than 100 wounded people from the besieged Croatian town of Vukovar. The mission was part of the latest ceasefire deal, which saw Croatian forces agreeing to lift their blockade of one of the main army bases in Zagreb. But the convoy, organised by the French aid charity Médecins Sans Frontières, came under mortar fire as it left Vukovar, and two nurses and a driver were seriously injured when their truck hit a landmine. Alex Thompson of ITN's Channel 4 News was with the convoy when it was attacked.
The jeeps of Federal Army commanders of the Vukovar area left their base just after 7 this morning, moving along tracks that are the only supply lines open across the minefields. They took up position facing the checkpoint that marks the end of the Federal Army's control zone and waited. At 8 a.m. the convoy arrived, carrying medical staff from the French aid agency Médecins Sans Frontières. A 16-vehicle group with 7 trucks to evacuate the wounded, believed to be more than 200. "I'm in a great hurry, gentlemen," the EC observer in control told the Federal Army. 1 mile out from Vukovar, a Federal tank group intended to meet and escort the convoy. Its soldiers dismantled their barricades in preparation. But it never arrived. Instead, the convoy had taken a different route to the north. Furious, federal commanders sent in their tanks to block that track to confront the convoy when it came out of Vukovar. Across the fields, the smoke of an artillery strike on the town proved that the ceasefire did not hold up today. Médecins Sans Frontières said they'd been trapped by shelling in the town. They were trapped again when they came out by federal army tanks, who insisted they travel by their route. So the convoy bounced over the fields. It could only have increased the pain of the 109 injured civilians on board these trucks. Michel Robert's patience was running thin.
My own purpose today is to lead a relief convoy with wounded people. That's all. And to withdraw from this town as much as possible wounded people.
And inside the trucks in great pain, they waited. Finally, the convoy rolled out past the federal lines, apparently on its way smoothly. And then this. An explosion near to the front of the convoy. A truck full of injured people had hit a mine between the federal and Croatian lines. The driver and two members of the aid team were blown clear of the cab. Doctors attended to them where they'd fallen. Next to the truck, another mine lay, hampering rescuers. Both sides call this a dirty war, and what more compelling image of that could there be than three people in a humanitarian convoy blown up by a mine on their way out of Vukovar? The agonizing process began of moving those already injured out of their wrecked evacuation truck. Nobody was killed in the blast, and this evening one of the two injured had reached a Federal Army field hospital. Médecins Sans Frontières said after the explosion they doubted whether another convoy would attempt to move in tomorrow. Alex Thompson, ITN, on the Vukovar front.
As the Mercy mission finally reached Vukovar, another convoy, this one laden with Federal Army soldiers and their weapons, was allowed to leave the Croatian capital Zagreb. The federal troops have spent the last 5 weeks under siege at their base. But today, the Croatian forces who encircled the Borongaj barracks allowed their enemy to go free. As the Serbian-led army moved out, the Croatians moved in. The flag of the breakaway republic hung from the